Hello and welcome! I'm Christoph Zapletal for Boris Effects, and in this quick tip we are going to take a look at some of the myths around your solver accuracy in SynthEyes, like why you're probably misunderstanding the HPix error, and why the tracker radar is such an important tool and will be your best friend in getting your solve from good to great. Let's go! A common conception is that to deliver a solid track, the HPix value needs to be below 1. While this is not wrong, it is only part of the equation. So what is the HPix? HPix stands for horizontal pixel error and illustrates the distance on the x-axis between a 2D tracker and its solved 3D counterpart. The further the distance between the two, the higher the HPix value. But your 2D trackers and their solved 3D counterparts being close to each other does not necessarily mean that the solved camera is correct. So before we continue, let's take a good look whether our initial solve makes sense when compared to the actual footage. If we take a look at our scene, we can see that we can identify the buildings, the ground, and we can see that the camera move SynthEyes came up with looks like what we would expect from this kind of shot. So we're good on that side. In a scene like this, we've got a number of trackers that make up the solve. If we zoom in here really closely, we can see two points. The yellow X shows us the solved position of our tracker in 3D space, while the green rhombus shows us its 2D position, the original track. What SynthEyes is doing now to come up with this HPix value for our scene is that it takes a look at all the individual trackers in the scene, takes the distance between the 2D tracker and its solved position in 3D space, and draws an average of all of them. If we click on an individual tracker, we can actually see the error curve mini view down on the right changing from the average value to the individual value. That number is now substantially higher than the average we saw before. But don't panic just yet. Once we switch to an individual tracker, the number shown is the maximum error, not the average. So let's take a look at this tracker. Right here around frame 103, it really peaks. Let's go to that frame and zoom in to see what's going on. And right here, our tracker drifts off to one side significantly. By the way, you can also lasso select a bunch of trackers and see the maximum error of those selected trackers. And if you select all of your trackers with the hotkey Command A if you're on a Mac or Control A if you're on a PC, you're getting a representation of the maximum error as well. Only if you deselect all trackers by either clicking anywhere but a tracker in our viewer or by using the hotkey Command D or Control D, you're getting back to the average value that we started with. And by the way, the HPix value is the same value as the error value shown up below the Go button in the solver room and also in your solver window once you finish processing a solve. There are cases where an HPix of above 1 might be acceptable, if you know the footage is going to be downrest before comp and delivery, a higher HPix might suffice. Same goes for certain other workflows, but in most cases you want to keep the HPix below 1. But why do we want to keep the HPix below 1? The simple answer is, if any object you put in your scene drifts less than 1 pixel, then no drifting should be visible and your final comp should look rock solid. But is this really achieved by bringing the overall HPix value below 1? Let's take a look at my error curve mini view down here. My average HPix is 0.981, so below 1 we should be good. But if we take a look here at frame 135, we do see a spike going into the red. Red is not good, because that means a drift of 2 pixels or more. So while our overall solve is really nice, any object we put in around here will likely drift or jump. So what can we do? Well, the first thing we can do is to use the cleanup trackers dialog to get rid of these trackers. Let's get rid of the worst trackers in our scene, the ones with the highest HPix value. We can flash them by hitting one of the select buttons, and that way we can see what kind of trackers SynthEyes would actually delete or curtail. And yes, SynthEyes will not necessarily delete all the bad trackers, but rather curtail them. That means it'll just ignore the part that causes the high error and keep the good data provided by that tracker for the rest of the solve. Still, there are cases where you want to really be able to take an individual tracker and manually modify it. So let's switch over to the tracking room. We could now click on each tracker and take a look at the error curve mini view to find out bad trackers causing a spike. But there's a much faster process using a great feature inside of SynthEyes, and that is the tracker radar. If we right-click in the viewer and go into the View submenu, we can turn on the tracker radar. Now we can see red circles of different sizes around our trackers. That makes identifying bad trackers really easy, because the bigger the circle, the bigger the HPix error for that tracker at that time. With the tracker radar turned on, we can now just go in here, open up the tracker, and use the traffic light controls to exclude the areas that we don't want to be considered for the solve. Of course, there can be trackers like this one that just have a bad HPix overall, so those can be deleted. If we now go to the solver room and refine our solve once again, we can see that the HPix moves down a little bit, but more importantly, that pesky spike is gone. So now we can be sure that our solve is solid across the entire frame range. I hope this demystified the HPix error for you. Leave us a comment what else you would like to see next. I'm Christoph Zapletal for Boris Effects. See you in another video.